Marks of the Beast, November 9, 2010. There are 666 marks or images of the beast in Revelation. There is no king but God. Everything belongs to God. God created the all. All the gold, all the silver, all the land, everything in the sky, and everything under the earth belongs to God. Haggai 2:8. Even your spouse and your children belong to God. The mark of the beast is money. Money is known as marks. Jesus asked, "Whose image is this on this coin?" Luke 20:24 and Mark 12:8-16. The people answered, "Caesar's." Jesus then replied, "Give to Caesar what belongs to Caesar, and give to God what belongs to God." The image or mark belongs to Caesar, but the silver that came out of the earth belongs to God. Each denomination of money has an image of one of the 666 beasts on it. Count them. There are 666, Revelation 13:18. We could say that the first beast was Caesar and the second beast was Nero. But whether or not Barack Obama is number 665 or 666, we don't know. It seems they stopped making money with beast or president's images on them in the Kennedy administration. Every piece of money has a king or president's image on it. But there is no king but God. Anyone who sets himself up as king is the devil. Who made you ruler over me? Is this because Kennedy is number 666? When Kennedy was in office, the government no longer had gold to back up its money. From 1963 on, money is known as notes or marks. It's simply a piece of paper representing a value. No man can buy or sell unless he receives one of these marks of the beast, the image of its name, or the number that represents its denomination. When you work, you're not serving God. You are serving the beast or the image that is on the dollar bill. You're working for Washington's, or you're working for Washington. Now, why is Washington considered a beast? Because President Washington is not God. In fact, he is against God because he is dividing up God's land, you know, collecting taxes off of God's land, God's gold, and he's forcing God's people into slavery called jobs. He's forcing mankind into slavery by passing laws making it mandatory that people purchase clothing in the $32 billion a year clothing industry. And this is because industries put him in power. It's industry that puts presidents in power and gets them elected. He's forcing people to pay taxes and rents on God's land. He's even making new laws that says companies like Monsanto can patent the seeds for God's apples and God's vegetables. And so he's making it as if corporations and industry actually owns the seeds to vegetables that been growing on and fruits that been growing on trees since the days Adam and Eve ate from the apple tree. He's changing God's laws of an eye for an eye, a tooth for a tooth, $1 trillion for $1 trillion worth of suffering into free rides for workers' compensation, why should they have to pay for the people they injured? When people start a business, they purchase insurance. The insurance sells them asks them how much insurance they want to purchase. A businessman knows that if he only purchases $50,000 worth of insurance and someone is injured costing $100,000, that the businessman is going to have to pony up the other $50,000. So a businessman will purchase $5 million worth of insurance. But he still knows that when someone suffers $10 million, he's going to have to pony up $5 million or suffer $5 million worth of pain. Now, if the businessman purchases $1 trillion worth of insurance and someone suffers $2 trillion, that business will suffer $1 trillion on Judgment Day. There's no free rides. They don't seem to be getting the message that you don't force people into slavery called jobs. You cannot buy or sell anything because everything belongs to God. As soon as you purchase something, you are purchasing stolen merchandise. And when you sell something, you are selling what belongs to God. Therefore, whoever receives the mark of the beast, the image of its name, or the number of its denomination will be cast alive into the lake of fire, where they will be burned and tortured forever and forever. Revelation 19:20.